नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माई सेल्फ जेवीएन डॉक्टर आस्था सिकरवार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ऑर्गन ऑफ मेडिसिन, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। माई टूडेज टॉपिक इज एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द पेशेंट फ्रॉम स्टुअर्ट क्लॉज फिलोसफी। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, He is reminding us that the purpose of our examination of a patient is to make a successful homeopathic prescription. The physician should keep in mind that our method of examining a patient varies according to the particular and in view that is homeopathic prescription. The technique of an examination for the purpose of diagnosing the disease is quite different from that of the examination for making a homeopathic prescription. He says physician as an ideal is greater than any medical specialist. He assures that the student who knows the nature, constitution, forms and varieties of symptoms necessary for the homeopathic prescription will find many things in a case than that of others who are specially trained only in pathology and general diagnosis, as they will entirely overlook. The selection of the homeopathic remedy is based very largely and sometimes almost entirely upon the phenomena or deductions drawn from the phenomena of subjective, concise experience perceived only by the patient and stated by him to the examiner. The most important thing in case taking is that with very few expectations, the most valuable indications for the remedy are to be found. They include subjective morbid sensations and phenomena which come within the sphere of the patient's own experience and are perceptible to him alone and objective science. We must, of course, depend entirely upon the statements of the patient himself. In our special examination, we should endeavor to put ourselves upon such a footing and in such personal relation to the patient as will best favor a full, frank revelation by him of all the circumstances and conditions that have led up to his illness and his sufferings. Guidelines for case taking. Consider two parts in examination of a patient: getting the history and symptoms from the patient's standpoint first, and physical examination. If the physical examination is made afterward when the patient is composed, there will be less danger of confusing or prejudicing his mind. The first part should be done in an easy, conversational manner. We should make him forget that he is under examination. We must first gain patient's confidence and relieve him from the sense of restraint and embarrassment. The physician's attitude should be calm and dignified, quiet and sympathetic, a demeanor confident but not pompous, simple and direct but not aggressive, cheerful but not flippant, serious but not grave or funeral, should be painstaking and systematic without being over formal. Senses must be on alert, mind clear, logical faculties acute, sympathies and prejudice held in abeyance. We should try to put the patient at his ease by adapting ourselves to his personality and mood. Should not confuse the patient by a too penetrating gaze at some objective feature which may attract our attention. If the patient sees us gazing fixedly at some part of his anatomy, he is likely to become anxious and forget other matters which are important. Nervous patients will easily get distracted by some simple procedures of examination, so it is best to postpone such examinations in them. The patient should be encouraged to tell his story freely in his own way without interruption and keeping the patient talking, but say little yourself during an examination. Patient should feel that he is relating his troubles to a sympathetic friend who has resources at hand to help him. We can give a starting by asking when and how his trouble began. We should not laugh at him nor pedantically correct his errors. We should not ask leading questions nor put words in his mouth, because afterwards we can analyze, complete, correct and interpret his statements in accordance with the homeopathic principles of symptomatology. It's well to leave a space between the symptoms so that we can easily glance back over the pages, and helpful to complete the symptoms by putting few more questions. To make three vertical columns in the page for collecting symptoms like date and remedy, symptoms, modalities and conditions. Should not hurry a patient in his narration, may quietly keep him to the point and prevent him from rambling inconsequently in statements by maintaining an attitude of business like absorption in the medical features of the case. He should determine what features of the case are medical, surgical, psychological, hygiene, sanitary, etc. Should keep some working classification of symptoms as general, particular, and common symptoms in mind. If we are to generalize correctly, we must have all the facts and be sure of them. First, analysis facts from the patient's statements, nurses, relatives, or friends' statements, and then our own observations. Then synthesize, review and study of symptoms and construction of the case. Comparison of symptoms, the patient with the symptoms of materia medica, in repertory, and final selection of indicated remedy. It's well to practice on the simple cases first in order to become familiar with the technique. Asking to read Organ of Medicine, as it helps to frame our questions. Laziness, selfishness, and easy concise are responsible for more homeopathic sins and shortcomings than anything else. The physician should get rid of this. There must be a constant warfare within ourselves until they are conquered by the establishment of correct methods and practice, and a genuine interest in the work is evolved. Prejudice and doubt may be overcome by reflection, study, self-discipline, and auto-suggestion, by cultivating the scientific spirits, strengthening morale, and correcting mental attitude, and should develop a more accurate, more practical and comprehensible technique. Obstacle like modesty from patients, from young and inexperienced physicians to be overcome. Guidelines for the clinical history recording. Getting a good clinical history is one of the most important and usually most neglected part of case taking. Following instructions should be followed. The complete list of patients' previous diseases from the childhood down to the present in chronological order, with ages at which the attacks appeared, their nature, symptoms, duration, severity, and sequel should be recorded in both acute and chronic diseases. In women and girls, inquire about the menses, age at which established, and regularity of the periods, deviations from the normal, time and influence of marriage, childbirth, etc. Vaccination history and treatment history should be inquired into. Personal history like accidents, mechanical injuries, or any mental shock should be inquired. Occupation, habits of patient, diet, exercise, sleep, use of tea, coffee, tobacco should be noted. Family history, a brief history of diseases, causes of death, predisposition and tendencies to diseases, and individual peculiarities of brothers, sisters, father, mother, uncles, aunts, grandparents, etc. if possible. These all examination gives the patient a confidence in the physician's professional ability and skill, and feels that he is interested in them and their families and knows all about him. A properly and systematically structured case record will facilitate the process of good history and case taking. The examiner should be alert and observing while making an oral examination. If the patient is confined to bed, the examiner will observe his position in bed, his manner of moving or turning, his respiration, the state of his skin, color and order of perspiration, order of exhalations from the mouth or body, physical appearance of excretions, relation of the patient's sensations to atmosphere and temperature as shown in amount of covering, ventilation of room, ice bags, hot water bottle, etc. will be valuable guides in the choice of remedy. Mental symptoms are of higher importance or getting them by observing general behavior, the conversation, the expression of countenance, desires and aversions, and the manner of sleeping, voluntary verbal expression, etc. Expertness in observing and analyzing these features of disease should be cultivated because right conclusions and effective treatment often depend more upon the physician's own observations and directions than upon anything that others or even the patient are able to tell him. Conclusion. Attention should be directed to the use and importance of logical analysis in the symptomatic examination of a patient. Should have close analysis to all elements of the case, concludes that to discover and bring out the facts of the case and give them form and individuality as a whole is an art. This session powered by digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention it in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.